Hello and welcome back. This is a quick update on the HP3438A multimeter that was donated by the Haybert channel and that we repaired in a previous episode. After an interesting fight with malfunctioning switches, we got it working perfectly, except for the Ohms function. The Ohms did work somewhat, but I could not zero out the 20 and 200 Ohms ranges properly. Moreover, I could only calibrate the 2 kilo ohms range successfully. At the time, I blamed it on the HP proprietary hybrid, which contains the analog switches and the precision resistors that control the current source, which is then used for all the resistance measurements. Furthermore, when the unit is in ohms mode, the hybrid chip is connected directly to the inputs and can be easily damaged by high voltage, a probable scenario for this former university lab instrument. Sadly, this hybrid chip is an Optanium, so I was content to have the 2 kilo ohm range working and left it at that. However, some astute commenters were skeptical of my diagnosis. It seemed really odd to them that I had a zeroing problem in some ohms range, but not others. After thinking about it for a minute, I have to agree with them. It's really weird and not really consistent with a current source problem. A current source issue would affect the max reading, but not the zero. Other commenters also pointed out that on this well-designed instrument, they'd expect to see some protection around the hybrid. So I went and checked the schematics more closely, and sure enough, the commenters were right. There is some protection circuitry. So maybe the hybrid chip is not dead after all, which would be mighty good news. That got me thinking about other failure modes. Let's give it another shot. Hello folks, this is a follow-up on the repair of the 3438A, the HP Digital DVM. I had problems with the ohms range, and you can see right now I am in short circuit and it's 5 and something ohms. And I thought it was due to the hybrid, the current source that was in there. But the people in the comments say that that could be something else. And first they noted that the hybrid should be protected. And this actually is the case. Maybe it didn't get blown up. So the way it does it is by the current source actually doesn't put current through the test resistor, it puts current through a reference resistor. The reference is in the hybrid. And then what happens is that the test resistor is put across an amplifier. And since it's an op amp, this point is always at 0 volts. So what the op amp is trying to do is going to nullify the current. So this point is always at 0 volt. If you look at here, it's even more simplified. You have 0.5 volts across a reference resistor that's in the hybrid, and you put your test resistance across the input amplifier, and it will just balance it, depending on the resistor. It's a voltage divider, assisted voltage divider, really. For example, in the 2K range, right? The reference resistor is 1K. So if you put an 1K test resistor, the current through the two resistors is 0.5 milliamp, and the output of this has to be minus 0.5 volts because it's a one-to-one voltage divider. So the current source shouldn't affect my zero point here. If you look at here and on the 20 ohms, I have 5.4 something, 200 ohms, same number. 2 kilo ohm, that was the only one I was able to calibrate, is at zero. Then 20 kilo ohm is at 0.5. This doesn't make any sense. I have a short over here. So if you look at the complete schematic, it gets super complicated because we are over here in that corner. This thing is actually our amplifier across which the resistor is put, and it's really hard to figure it out because it gets rewired a million ways. The resistor is across here, protection circuit, then over here, other pin, and this somehow gets rewired to the input here. So that's pretty hard to follow, but they have a simplified schematic over here, which is way easier to follow because it basically tells you how the amps are wired in AC amps, DC, or ohms, which is of interest to us. Here's the source and the hybrid. Then you see there's protection here, there's two diodes. And then here's U1. And here is the leads, that's where the resistor, test resistor is. But there's more to it, there's this circuit, so if this, which is a protection circuit. I'm unsure how it works. But if this were to be wonky, that could be our problem. Then there's another protection over here at the end. So it's protected on both sides, and then this is protected too, which is a good news. So I'm thinking either the protection is blown, and one of those is shorted, or if you look really closely, there are a few drill switches in the way, S6, and there is also another one. On the current source, there are no switches in the analog path. It's all MOSFETs that do the switching on the hybrid. But there are a bunch of switches that are in the analog path here. But they are very hard to find. There's this one. The kilo ohm switch is this guy. And then there is those two, which is a front-back switch. So if the switch have any residual resistance, that could be a problem, that could cause our problem. So the 20 ohms, this is not going to do anything because it switches the current source over here. This one shouldn't do anything. This one shouldn't do anything. This one could. This one is straight in the path, the kilo ohm, right here. No, it switches this input here from either ground in voltage measurement or to the output of our U1 amplifier in ohms. So this one is in circuit. I would feel if something happened, I would feel it. So that I don't see any difference. So I don't think it's a bad contact in the switches. There's one more. There's a front back switch. But no, from what I saw, I'm tempted to say it's the protection circuit that doesn't work. But let's try the front back switch just to be sure. So back on the rear front, as it says. Ah! What? So that went from 5 ohms to 0.5 ohms? And we found the fault? Oh yeah. That's our problem. I had cleaned that one, but not dismantled it like I did the others. Okay guys, I think we've found our problem. Let's see if it became 0.3 on this one. Yep. Here it went to 0.6. So there's still something I don't understand. But if I zeroed it wrong, you know, on the 2 kilo ohms, I could have compensated for the resistance of this with the zero, and then I would have gotten the gain wrong. Okay, now it's repeatable. I'm going to give it a good look, but the hopes are high here. Actually, looking at it, let's see if I can focus on it. I don't know if you can see, but I think the switch is corroded. There's some blue stuff on the gold, which is usually when the copper underneath starts to corrode. So, more cleaning, see if I can get the corrosion off. And I didn't put deoxy gold, I put just regular deoxy because the other contacts Oh, it's really pitted. Well, I'll turn this around, that's gonna be easier. Okay, so there are several issues, like, you know, how good is my short here, because we're measuring very low voltages, or very low resistance. So that's 0.39.4. Okay, so that's reproducibly good. Now I'm trying the back. Let's see what we get at the back. 0.5, but I have a little longer connections. Oh! Okay, now it's 0.1. Okay. I need, this guy's no good. I need a better jumper. So I'm not trying it again. So this is a two-wire measurement, so it's not going to be anywhere as good. 0.47 over here. Reproducibly so. And at the back, 0.47, okay. All right, so I think right now I'm measuring the zero of the amplifier. We'll redo the 0 ohm calibration over here. All right, so it was. So now I can zero it. And it should stay zero across the ranges. It does. Okay. Let's see what they say in the manual, but I think I'm correct. Okay, so experience proves that doing it the way the manual says is the best. So reading 0 ohm to correct everything at the plug, and then adjusting it for 19 at the 19K. And then now I'm getting, if I get into auto range, I get a good results. So we'll start with something really low, like let's say 50 ohms. It's 50.1 because it's the cabling. And then let's get it to change. Range 590. Then we'll go to 85.3. There you go. 55.85. I get it. Let's get it one more digit here. 98.1085. That is correct. So, I think, thanks to the community here of commenters were right. It was not the hybrid, and it was a contact that was in series the whole thing, and it was actually this one over there, which I thought I cleaned, but not well enough. So, thank you everybody. Thanks to the community, this thing is fully repaired and trustable.